Hello everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and as you can see here, we're a little off track compared to where we were before, but just a couple things to get out of the way before we actually start continuing forward. First of all, I can imagine that those of you who saw the rare candy was like, give it to Shotgun already! So, you know what? Here. There. We gave it to Shotgun. Yay, you got over. Yay. Over 100 health. And oh my god, he's evolving again! What? No way! Oh my god, look at that! Oh, just look at it. Wow, it looks really gay. Congratulations, your shotgun evolved into Blaziken. Shotgun is trying to learn Blaze Kick, but Shotgun can't learn more than 4 moves. Frickin' right we're going to. Now look at that. A kick with a high critical hit ratio may cause a burn with 85 by 90 accuracy. So essentially, a fire type crab hammer, which that's pretty awesome. You know, when you think about it, that's kind of cool. So let's look at these, like, ripped stats here. Let's look at how amazing he is. I have to admit, he's pretty awesome. I have to admit, that's pretty sick. Those are pretty sick stats. Like, look at those. He could be faster, but eh. I've seen slower. So, anyway. Yeah, and also, I took Nincada back from the daycare, and he only needs 370 more experience till he evolves. So, what we're gonna do is, we're just gonna go out here, and we're going to, get rid of some Magnemite. I've already defeated a few of these people. So, just to show you guys, because I know that most of you probably already know about Shedinja and stuff, but, you know, just to show you guys that I have one. You know, just for the sake of having one, I guess, since I got a Shedinja, or since I got a Nincada and he's this level. I just decided to check on him one time, when I came back here, and I was like, oh my god. He's of level. Wow, he's level 19. That's really convenient, right? So, I don't know, I thought it was kind of neat that, you know, he was this level and stuff, so. Alright, wow, we're so close. Come on, man. Alright, there's one more, I think. Yeah, there's one more. Well, I think two more people. Get over here. Oh, come on! Get over. You're gonna fight me and you're gonna freaking like it. My thighs are like rocks. Well, that's nice. It sounds like really relaxing. Yeah. You know, to have your thighs be, you know, related to such a thing. As lifeless and, you know, solid as a rock. Yeah. Alright, so there we go. There, he's level 20. Yay.
Yay!
So, here we go. Another Magnemite. I'm still not quite sure what type of hidden power that is. I'm thinking because I'm killing off the Magnemite so easily with it, that it's probably ground. Because, like, that's the only... Unless maybe fighting. I guess we're about to figure out once we fight this Voltorb. If it's super effective against the Voltorb, then it's definitely ground. Then, if not, I'd probably guess it's fighting. Would you look at that? It's ground. And we get stab off of it because it's freaking Nincada. That's pretty awesome. I have to admit. It's pretty sick. But we won't be getting stab off of it anymore. Because now, our Nincada is evolving into a Ninjask! Oh, with the ninja training, you will make a most honorable pupil, Ninjask. Yeah, so our Nincada evolved into Ninjask, you know, like, yay, great, right? No, we don't want to learn Double Team. Double Team kind of sucks. Trying to learn Fury Cutter. That's an okay move. We can teach him Fury Cutter. You know, like, we can get rid of Mind Reader. Like, why would we want Mind Reader? That kind of sucks. So. Yeah, we learned it, yay. And Screech. Again, you know, not the best move. I don't think I'm going to teach it to him. But, and look at that. There we go. And in this sixth slot, you have to keep a spare slot. But in this spare slot here, we have a Shedinja right here. Right here, right now. Not really the best, because he's a bold nature, so he kind of sucks, but... And this, yeah, this Ninjask pretty much sucks too. But, you know, just for the sake of saying we have it, I guess. So I'm going to go deposit both of them now. Also, the egg hatched as well, just so you guys know. Just for the sake of knowing. Yeah, the egg hatched, which is kind of cool. he hatched into the why not, yeah. For those of you that have played through the game before, you would know that the egg hatches into a why not. And I named the why not Bob Saget. And I know, it sounds weird, but I named him Bob Saget because why not is actually, he actually got his name because of a famous Japanese comedian whose catchphrase was like some Japanese word that was basically an English translation for why not. I don't know, I always thought it was kind of funny. Wobbuffet's name is actually the exact same concept, except it's like the second part of his catchphrase. So like the two of them are like two parts of the same catchphrase from some famous Japanese comedian. So I thought it was funny because, you know, Bob Saget is such a famous, like, American comedian. So, I don't know, I just thought it was kind of a funny little link to make. Name him Bob Saget. Plus, Bob Saget, I mean, like, that's just a funny name in itself. And Bob Saget himself, like, he would be proud to have his why not named, to have my why not named after him. I think he'd be really appreciative of that. I think he'd really be, like, deeply moved by that kind of gesture that I did for him, so... You know, here's a shout out to you, Mr. Saget, you know? Old Saggy. Oh, that was really... Old Saggy. Yeah, that's what we call him, you know? That's what we called him back in the high school day. What am I talking about? I am in high school. I went to high school with him once, though. It was pretty great. It was a fun time. He was always the class clown. It was funny, though, because he had that really funny looking, like, pseudo mullet hair kind of thing going. It was kind of cool, you know, back in our glory days. We go way back. It's kind of great. Okay, anyway, one more thing that I've done. Did I mention it already? I don't know if I did. I actually came through with what I said last episode, and I taught everybody hidden power. Everybody has it. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to go find a Kecleon in the wild, one that we can actually encounter. There's one over there by the gym. You can't get to the gym till you take out the Kecleon there, but you can't fight him, so he's not really of any use to us. So we're just going to use this one over here. And basically all we're going to do is we're going to test to see what types are which. So first up is Jaws. And it's great that I got intimidated on the first run through here. So we're going to use Hidden Power. Okay. So Ice type. So an Ice type Hidden Power, that kind of really sucks. Because Jaws already has Ice Beam. So, you know, like, that's completely useless on him, really. So we know that, you know, that's not that great on him. So now we'll send in Shotgun. Who now looks like a big beastly thing. Like, holy crap, look at him. He looks like a beast, but, I don't like Blaziken, but I really don't. I hate them. Oh, that was super effective. What type was that? What type was that? It was physical, and it killed him in one hit. So that means it probably wasn't a special-based move. So that means it could have either been Steel, Rock, or Fighting. And if it's a Rock type, that's great. If it's a Steel type move, that's okay. Not really anything big, really. Not really getting any phenomenal coverage right there. And if it was Fighting, then... again, I guess that's okay, but... It still kind of sucks, really. But, I don't know. I guess. We can continue to fight different Pokemon to narrow it down, though. We can, like, obviously, if I use Hidden Power against the Swablu, it's going to be super effective, because he's Ice-type. It's Ice-type Hidden Power. But... Judging by the things we've done against that Kecleon with the typing it had at the time, which was Ice, we can safely assume that if it hits neutral damage, it's going to be either a Fighting or... probably either a Fighting or a Steel-type attack. It could have been a Fire-type move, but I don't know. But we're about to figure it out here. This will help us narrow it down even more, thanks to that Ice typing. So that was... Neutrally effective. So, you know, like, that could have been anything. That doesn't really narrow it down much more. Basically, the only thing it tells us is that it wasn't a rock-type move, because otherwise Swablu would have taken super effective damage from it. So, my only guess is that it might have been a fire-type move. Swablu survived it, but I don't remember whether Swablu have higher defense or special defense, right? So, I guess what we're going to do is we're just going to go up against another guy here. I think, is this the guy with the Natu and the Zatu? Yeah, this is the guy with the Natu and the Zatu. Or something like that. Natu Swellow, maybe. I don't remember, to be honest. And we're going to use Hidden Power again. And if this is not very effective, we'll know that it's not fighting type. And it was neutral. So again, we know that now it's not fighting or rock type move. So my only best guess is that it's going to be either steel type or a fire type. Neither one really provide that great of coverage, really. But we'll see what the next Pokemon is, and we'll try to narrow it down. This is a Swellow, and it's basically going to have the same coverage as the against the Swablu, since they're the same type. So we'll just move on to a different guy, and we'll try to figure this all out. You know, put the puzzle together. This is what I always found fun. I always find this fun, you know, figuring out what type of hidden power your Pokemon have. I like the problem-solving aspect of it all. So let's see what this Swellow... Let's see what this does against the Swellow. Okay, so it's neutral. So, a lot of things we know already. It's not a fighting type. It's not rock. It's not electric. It's not ice. And it's not ground. And it's not ghost. So we've actually knocked out quite a few possibilities just by using that. Plus, it didn't do much damage, so my best guess is that it's also probably going to be a special type move. So that basically knocks out all the other physical types. Because coming off of Sunny's massive attack stat, that should have done a lot more. So, we'll just find another guy here. This might be an interesting one to use for Sunny over here. This ninja boy. Here we go. Ninja boy. Oh, we also know that Sunny's hidden power is not bug or grass either, because that's what flying types also resist. So, we've knocked out quite a few possibilities with that one. This might be where things get narrowed down. This is a pretty exploitable typing that Nincada has, so this will probably give us a few answers. So this was super effective. So that tells me that the typing is probably either fire or water, I would say. Probably either fire or water. Possibly flying. It could be flying type. We'll see here. This will be another one that will give us more answers. So the rain's continuing to fall. So let's see here. And that's neutral. So that takes out the possibility that it could have been fire. Because if it was fire, then it would have done super effective to both of them. It also takes out the possibility that it was ice, because it's also super effective to both of them. So that leads me to believe that hidden power on Sunny is a water type hidden power. Which is, that's actually pretty awesome. To have a normal type move, a rock type move, a fire type move, and a water type move on one Pokemon. That's pretty sick. So, you know, that's always good. Might be fun to use, you know, disregarding that low special attack, but, you know. Fire. No, that wouldn't really do much. Did we already figure out Ziplocks? I don't remember. Oh, yeah, we figured it out. We said it was, ground, didn't we? Didn't we think it was ground? Or no, we figured out it was ground. I don't know. I don't remember. Yeah, makes ground moves miss. So, that's basically the end of the episode. I spent this whole episode showing you guys stuff and trying to figure out special or hidden power types. So we've come to the conclusions that Sunny has a water-type hidden power, Jaws has an ice-type hidden power, Ziplock has a ground-type hidden power, and Shotgun has either a fire or a fighting-type hidden power. I'll stretch the episode out a little more, just because, you know, I didn't get much in. So I'll stretch it out just a little bit more. And plus, so we can, so we can, confirm shotgun. So since we think it's either going to be a, did I say fire or fighting? I meant fire or, steel, I think. So, if it's going to be a fire-type move, that means that it gets weakened in this weather, and it's not going to do well against this. Against, this lady here. So, actually, I don't think this will give us any more. I don't think this will give us any more, Oh, okay, well, maybe. Maybe. You never know. Alright, so this is turning him into the water-type cast form. This is what a cast form is, by the way. This is what I missed out on when the person at the Weather Institute said to take a Pokemon. So let's see. This shouldn't be very effective. No. I didn't think it was going to be. Okay, so here's a sunny day. Although, for not being very effective, that did an awful lot of damage. Did you notice that? So, Shaboom. That also didn't do much. It did a lot more, though. So, again, judging by that, I would have to say that because of the damage difference, once the rain went away and the sun came out, I'm going to have to assume that this is a fire-type hidden power, I would say. Yeah, definitely. It's definitely a fire-type hidden power. And that's basically useless, since we have Blaze Kick, so, you know, that sucks. That sucks that two of our hidden power types are completely useless. But, you know, that's fine. I can teach them different moves and stuff, so. Anyway, that's the end of the episode. Basically, wow, this was a very educational episode. You know, just basic techniques of method of deduction and stuff. Anyway. Oh, I forgot Zigzagoon! Dang it! That's where you can get another hidden rare candy, I think, up there. I think. Oh, maybe it's a different spot I'm thinking of. Anyway. I hope you have a very good life, or afterlife, if your hidden power moves on shotgun and freaking Jaws looking to kill me in the next episode, because you're useless to me. Which is a shame. Peace.